Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to start with basic data management in R programming. This is the part one of this series. In this particular video, we are going to learn how to construct the basic data frames. I'm your instructor, Rajesh Durbala, and I'm an assistant professor in business analytics and research methodology. Moving ahead. We'll start with a basic working example, and I'll be using this example throughout to understand how to work with basic data management. Okay, so what is this example? Now, for instance, let us say I wish to study how men and women differ in the way they lead their organizations. Now, the typical questions that might arise would be, do men and women in management positions differ in the degree to which they defer to supervisors or superiors? Or the other question could be, does this vary from country to country, or are these gender differences universal? Now, these are certain research questions, okay, that are of my interest. Now, I'll go ahead collecting data for the same. Now, when I collect the data, one way to address these questions is to have the bosses in multiple countries rate their managers on differential behavior using some questions somewhat like this. This manager asks my opinion before making personal decisions, and I'm asking them to rate them on a Likert scale. It has to be 5 over here. So 1 is strongly disagree, 2 is disagree, 3 is neither agree nor disagree, that is neutral, 4 is agree, and 5 strongly agree. Okay, now this is a question, and how the respondent would be rating. Okay, now this is how a typical data, if I conduct a research, this is how a typical data would look like. Now, these are various managers, these are the dates on which the responses were collected, these are the countries, the gender, age. This is the response for question 1, response for question 2, response for question 3, and so on. Okay, here you can see two blanks, that is to say there was no response. So now, how am I going to deal with this? The first step that we are going to do is we are going to construct a basic data frame. Okay, now how do we construct a data frame? We have to pull out every variable and create vectors out of it. Okay, so for manager, I create a vector like this with a C command. For date, I create a vector. You can see these double quotes, that is to say I am considering these dates as characters, because if I consider them as numeric, then when I enter this format into the R program, the division will take place and you won't get the date format. So you have to consider that as a character vector and put it in double quotes. And country, so same way, this is also a character. Gender, a character. Age, a vector for age. Q1 for responses for question 1, Q2, Q3, Q4, and so on. Okay, so the final data frame that you would get, it would be created. I'm giving a name to this data frame as leadership, and the data frame would be created using the command data.frame. Okay, data.frame, and in brackets I'll use all these vectors that I have created, that is manager, date, country, gender, age, and all the 5 questions. And I'll keep the strings as false, strings as factors equals to false. Okay, now let us get into our R software and run this commands and see how it works. Okay, now I have just pasted all those commands over here so that it saves a lot of time. Now I have created vectors for all. Right, so this is a vector for manager. Run this, then I have a vector for date, run that. It says there is an unexpected error. What is that error? Let's see. I don't know, it seems good. Then I have country. Gender. Then I have age, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, and now you can see I did not get any error for any of the numeric vectors, but I got some error for character vectors. It could be possible because I have pasted them directly from my PPT, so it could be possible that there could be some formatting errors. If I rewrite them again, this error won't exist. Okay, now let's do it and see. Okay, just I'm rechecking all the double quotes so that there won't be any error, and preferably my R is reading them properly. Since I directly copied from my slides, this kind of error usually happens. So you should be careful while doing these tasks so that these things do not happen. Okay, I deliberately wanted you to see this and understand when you encounter such kind of an issues, how to handle such issues. Okay, now you can see when I just changed my double quotes, everything is perfect. Okay, so this is what I wanted to see, and I wanted you to see this as well, so that in future whenever you encounter these problems, you know how to troubleshoot them. Okay, so whenever you are pasting something, copying and pasting something from other source, you have to be careful that these double quotes usually are not read correctly by R. Okay, now you can see my country also is perfect. Now coming to this gender, this is the last vector where we encountered this problem. So you should be clear that it was a clear error with the double quotes. Okay, that's F and double quotes. Okay, so we are almost done with this. Okay, run this. Right, so all my vectors are correct. Okay, now just I'll clean this so that my order remains intact. I'll run all of them once again and I'll create a data frame. So basically what have you learned is creating the vectors. Okay, and doing some basic troubleshooting with respect to your character vectors. Okay, when you copy paste something, there are bound to be certain errors, so you have to know how to troubleshoot those errors. Okay, now all my vectors are created. The last step, that is I'm creating a data frame. Okay, the name of the data frame is leadership. So once I run this, you can see there was this brackets missing, so that could also have given me an error. Okay, now once I run this, this is my vector or data frame called leadership created. Now just once I run this leadership, okay, this is my leadership data frame. Now once I run this, it creates my data frame. You can see this is how my data frame looks like: the managers, dates, country, gender, age, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and Q5. Perfect. So this is how we construct data frames in R. So what are the things that we have learned is, number one, creating the vectors. Number two, troubleshooting in case of character vectors. And number three, how to construct data frames. You can get in touch with me on LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter. You can write to me at rajeshdurbala@gmail.com. Keep visiting my channel and do subscribe to it. Thank you for today. Have a nice day.